Find the best UX roadmap tool to elevate your design and research process. Let's look into the pros and cons of 5 top choices so you can make updates easier, enhance collaboration, and ensure everyone is aligned. If you're not familiar with what a UX roadmap is, check out this video first. Now, let's look at the 5 most common options we saw teams using in our research and see why each one might be a good fit for you or not. First up, PowerPoint or other presentation tools. Presentation tools are versatile, widely available, and highly familiar tools. So it doesn't require any specific training to build your roadmaps in these tools, to customize them, or to keep them updated. The disadvantages of this are that collaborating with others and tracking changes can be tricky. Also, with slides, there's a tendency to share the roadmap prematurely before developing a strong narrative to present to stakeholders. Still, this could be a great option for you if your team has no extra budget for specialized tools, if you're highly motivated to get started building a roadmap as soon as possible, there's no tech onboarding necessary. You could even start immediately after this video. Next, we have spreadsheets like Excel or Google Sheets. We could also include other popular table-based tools like Notion and Airtable in this category. In our research, we saw people love to use these tools because they're highly customizable, they're really good for detailed data management, and like presentation tools, they're widely available and affordable. There are 2 main disadvantages, though. First, I'll admit, they're often not the most visually appealing, which unfortunately means that stakeholders can perceive them as more difficult to understand. Second, because they lend themselves to manage detailed data so well, it's easy for them to become overloaded with granular details and tasks rather than helping teams focus on those high-level problems to solve. Choose a spreadsheet if your team already uses them for lots of work and if you have a strong need for organizing lots of types of data within your roadmap. Our next tool is the digital whiteboard. Tools like Miro, Mural, FigJam, or Excalidraw. The advantages of whiteboards are that a lot of UX and product professionals are comfortable with virtual sticky notes and moving them around to organize ideas. They're great for brainstorming, and the unlimited canvas size can be wonderful for creativity and productivity. The downsides of these tools are that they can become cluttered. Think in comparison to the strict table grids of a spreadsheet. And they require a learning curve for people who aren't used to them. And because most UX roadmaps will be discussed in collaboration with other teams, you may be inadvertently putting up a barrier to some folks. If that's not the case for your situation, they can be a wonderful and collaborative way to manage roadmaps. Choose these tools if you require flexibility and if everyone's already familiar with the platform. Project management tools like Trello, Jira, Confluence also offer robust roadmap features, and many UX practitioners use them for that reason. The teams that love using these tools for their UX roadmaps love them because they integrate with their existing product backlogs or are already systems the team uses for other parts of their product management. They also have built-in systems and automated notifications and updates. However, these kinds of tools can be pricey and complex to set up. They might offer more features than necessary for simpler roadmaps. I recommend using a project management tool for UX roadmaps if you're in a large organization with many teams trying to connect their UX work together, and if your team is readily comfortable with complex systems. Finally, specialized roadmapping platforms provide focused solutions. The advantages of these dedicated applications are that they are purpose-built for managing roadmaps. They're customizable, visually appealing, and have plenty of features to support the level of detail your team wants, and to help effectively share the roadmap with your collaborators and stakeholders. The disadvantages, similar to using a project management tool, are costs. They can be expensive, and they do have a learning curve because they're so specialized. Still, plenty of teams find it worth those trade-offs to manage their roadmapping across products and UX specialties. These could be great if you manage a lot of roadmaps. There you have it. Each tool offers unique advantages, but also has some weaknesses. The best tool for you will depend on your specific needs. Consider your project's complexity, team size, and requirements. Whichever direction you choose, I hope you'll check out our other videos for more insight into how to make the most out of your UX roadmaps.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.